Okay, I'm going to try a little something a little different today. I'm going to do a little sculptures on stream, which I've never done before. Hopefully my cam setup is okay. If there's anyone here, please let me know if you can hear me and see me all right. This is a little sculpture that I did last night of a little cat, little witch cat. And I am using Super Sculpty polymer clay. And after I bake this, I will paint it. Monkey is here on my desk. She's coming to say hi. I don't know if I can move my camera without messing everything up. Monkey? Here's Monkey! Kind of. Well, you get the idea. There's a kitty over there. Okay. And here's another sculpt I did. I've been working on making little pumpkin toads for Halloween. This is my first one. It's got cat fur on it now. And here's a few more that I did. Try to adjust this again. There we go. Little pumpkin toads. Okay, I'm going to put these guys out of the way, and I'm going to put the cat somewhere where it won't get fur on it, because I don't want it to get dirty before I bake it, because this clay is still soft. And I will be right back. Okay. So usually what I do is I start out with like a piece of aluminum foil, and then I put a thin layer over it of the polymer clay. And I did that already on this one because it takes a while to knead the polymer clay and get it soft. Because it starts out in a big block like this. And it's kind of hard to start out with. So you gotta kind of like knead it to get it nice and soft. So I did one already to start with the aluminum foil inside it already. And I got my little box of eyes. And I have to decide what kind of eye I want, because that's the... Oh, actually, usually I do the mouth first. I usually stick like a little mouth on here using a little roll. Boop. I kind of smooth it down with the back of my fingernail because my fingernails are good tools for that. Then I usually, after that, I pick the eyes out. So, I gotta decide what color eyes I want for this guy. I put purple eyes on my last one. We might do green eyes for this one. We'll see what kind of colors I've got here going. That's kind of a nice color. Let's see if I can find the matching one. There. And it has that little tint of blue on it. I'm going to go with these two eyes. Let's see if I can adjust my camera again. It might be bumpy, hang on. There. I shouldn't have bent it earlier so you could see monkey. No, I'm not gonna get it back where I had it. Sure if I need some more light. Yeah, I don't think that makes much difference. Maybe that's a little better. Monkey, you don't need to be meowing. Why don't you come up over here? Switch the music. Hi, Silent. How are you doing today? Hopefully you're doing a little bit better. Yeah. I've never tried sculpting on stream before, so I don't know how well this is working, but your insurance won't cover your physical therapy without a referral from primary care from a physician. I've literally never seen that before. Who is in Texas? It has to be this specific, huh? Oh, sure, no problem. Thanks for stopping by. Oh, thank you. I love making these little toads. Toads even, yeah, I figured that's what you meant. Monkey, why are you having a meowing tantrum? Come up here. I don't know if you can hear Monkey meowing. She is a talker. She wants me to pet her and I'm gonna get her fur all in my clay. But she can be very vocal. She's been very demanding the last few days.
Haven't you?
Yeah. Actually, I think that lawnmower quit, so would you like it if I opened the window? Maybe we'll open the window for her.
Here we go, Monkey. We'll crack the window open for you.
It's nice out today. Oh, your fur is just everywhere. Okay. Yep, there's monkey fur. That is a problem with, like, trying to sculpt by my desk. There is monkey fur everywhere on my desk. These little toads go actually pretty fast. Now that I've got a technique down, I'm making them. Was working on my mushroom hat earlier, so my fingernails probably look dirty. I probably got paint on them. I don't know if you can tell that from the cam or not. I probably should have cleaned them before I came on. This is paint, though. Thank you. I was showing off some of my finished pumpkin toads that I did earlier. I could probably grab one from over here, since they're still right here. I made some more for the Halloween market that's coming up. I thought it'd be nice to have some, like, autumn themed. I don't know that I can get the camera to focus. I'm like terrible at that, but here's another one. This one's kind of squat. I'll probably be putting these up on Instagram soon, so. I always think up is down and down is up. And I never know where I'm going on camera. Trying to watch what I'm doing, but there we go. Big chunk of clay here. It starts out all crumbly.
pieces.
Hang on a second. Okay. Bye. Bye to you too, Silent. Excuse me. Oh, thank you. Have a good time at class. Oops, I'm not on screen. Actually, you know what might be fun? Hang on a sec. Oops. This one I think is gonna be a wizard toad, so we could give him a little shiny goober, maybe. Might want to squish it into his stomach. Yeah. That's cool. Do you need a tree? Have a tree. Okay. Distractions. Okay. So now he's got a little shiny stone. Pretty. Try to smooth his arm out here so it actually looks like it's attached to him. Thank you. Let's make a hat for him.
Everyone hears you, monkey. Everybody hears you. Meow.
Good for strengthening the hands. A lot of clay kneading. It makes your fingers strong. Let's give this little guy some ears. Give him ears before he can have his hat. There's his hat. Let's give him kind of a wonky hat. There we go. leaves on his hat. He's looking pretty cute. Cute little wizard or witch. Toad. Let's give him some warts. Not really warts, they're just bumps. Little skin bumps. Little skin texture. You cannot actually get warts if you handle a toad. Although you should be careful with them because, one, they breathe through their skin. Well, not all the... They don't, like, completely breathe through their skin, but they do absorb a lot of like oxygen and stuff through their skin, so when you're handling them, the oils in your hand can actually harm a toad if your hands aren't too wet or damp, because it can clog their skin up if you handle them too much. And also that goes for like most amphibians like toads and frogs. And also some toads have poison glands on the back of their head, which is actually what I said was his ears, could be considered the poison gland. So obviously these little guys are very stylized and very fantasy, so, you know. They're just cute little guys. Sometimes they put a few on the front. He could have a little bump on his arm. A little bump on his cheek. Go, I think. As far as the sculpting goes, he may be finished. And I'm gonna just take the cat fur off of him again. Smooth out his bottom. My initials in. The date. And then he'll be ready to bake. Here's some other sculpts that I'm probably going to bake with them. I did a couple little owls, which I think turned out really cute. I got this little owl and a skull. wings. And I've got this little wizard owl. Got this other little toad with a crystal. Now this toad is kind of neat because I actually gave him eyes that I made out of resin. So he's actually got special eyes. And he's got a little amethyst crystal too. I've got this kitty that I'm gonna bake along with this group. So I've got a pretty good group going. I'll probably have to do a bake soon. And then I'll do painting. Which I'm not sure if I can do painting by my desk or not. I feel like I probably shouldn't, because I probably will end up getting paint all over if I do that. But now that I have an idea of how to set my camera up for these kind of streams, I might have to do some more traditional art streams in the future. Maybe like some sketching or drawing or... Or, of course, more sculpting. What I might do today, if I can get another toad done, or another little sculpt, maybe I'll do another owl. Play some more chicory for a while. Or I could do that this weekend. We'll see how I feel. Watching me knead clay probably isn't as exciting as watching me sculpt. Although I don't think of myself being very exciting in general, but... Probably should have softened some more up before streaming today, but that's just how it is. Go get some more aluminum foil. if there's anyone new here, I am Erin, also known online as Shadow Wind, and I create all sorts of art. I do digital illustrations and paintings, and I also do obviously sculpting. And I do traditional art also. I do like acrylic paintings and watercolor paintings occasionally, though I've never done that on stream. This is my first time trying to sculpt on stream. And if you're here, thank you for being here and watching. Feel free to say hi in the chat. I get concentrating and I'm not real good at talking during my streams, but hopefully I will get better. I do have a mailing list that I send out free coloring pages every month, and I have illustrated a few coloring books. I've illustrated a dragon coloring book, and I've illustrated a Mytharen creatures coloring book, which was a collaboration with Oneshi Press. I think it turned out really cool. See if I can do a shout out. Does that work? It did not work. Let's try this one. My bots aren't doing anything today. Well, you can find those links other places, so sorry about that, but I'm gonna have to go look at my bots again and try to figure out why they don't always work. I could have sworn I had Stream Elements working the other day. I actually thought I had Nightbot set up too, so I don't know. Maybe they're conflicting with each other or something. I have no idea. I don't know anything about bots. But if you do want to find out more about Oneshi Press and the work that they do, JL streams every Tuesday and Thursday. For me, it's about at 7 o'clock, but I'm Eastern Standard Time. And they will be coming out with a new comics anthology soon. And I collaborated with someone else on that, Technicolorful. I helped her with her comic, doing some of the coloring work for her. So that'll be fun. I have a couple reasons for using aluminum foil. This part is probably kind of boring, but I do have a couple reasons for using aluminum foil inside my sculptures. The first is I use a little less clay that way, and this clay is kind of expensive. The second is when it bakes, the aluminum foil heats up from the inside, so it kind of will bake from the inside as well as from the outside. So I think it kind of makes it stronger when it's finished. And that is actually the third and main reason, is because it does strengthen it. And especially on the bigger sculpts, I usually use a little bit of wire too for things like the legs and the tails, to try to make it as strong as I can, because sometimes I get a little fiddly and thin, and I like my sculptures to hold up, so I try to make them as sturdy as I possibly can. So now I've got it all covered in clay. I'm going to try to smooth it out a little, because it's kind of lumpy. This is going to be an owl. I'm going to figure out which side. I think this side should be the face. And I need to figure out what eyes I'm going to do on my owl. My little treasure trove of eyes. I probably want some bigger eyes for this one. I don't really think of owls as having slit pupils like a reptile. I think of them as having more rounded pupils. So maybe these eyes? I think I have some more of this size on the other side of my little eyeball box. So let's look and see what else I have. Green. That's a little big though. I think I'm gonna stick with the gold ones. Ooh, I do have these, but I kinda wanna save these for something special. These are really shiny and they're really dark purple. Purpley blue. I don't think they really show up very well on my webcam, but they are very sparkly. I'm gonna have to try to do some more like that. I think we're going to stick with the gold ones. Now these eyes that I make, sometimes they get a bit of a film over them when I'm working with the clay and touching them. I think that probably has something to do with the UV drying resin, but what I usually will do before I bake them is I'll get a little rubbing alcohol and I'll just take a paintbrush and paint over the top of them, and it usually clears them right up. smaller, actually. least one of my bots is working. My Ko-Fi bot is working. Hopefully it's not too annoying there. I might need to space out how often it does that. Oops. Everybody out there is having a nice Friday today. I think it's Friday. Yeah, it's Friday. Sometimes I lose track. Thank you for the sub, Silent. Oh, Shy Wolf. That was Shy Wolf giving silent. Oh, gifting. Okay, cool. Thank you very much for gifting the subs, Shy Wolf. I need to look closer when I read chat. That was very nice of you. Oops, Monkey heard me talking and came back out. She woke up from her nap. Yeah, did you wake up from your nap, Monkey? We're almost done with this little owl. Give him a little hat. Hat band. I see you, my kitten. Making some little feather textures. Oh, we got another sub, Shy Wolf. Thank you. Not too bad. Keeping busy. I've got a market coming up on October the 8th, I believe. It's either the 8th or the 7th, whatever day Saturday is. And it's going to be a Halloween market. So I've been trying to get stuff done for that. And I'd like to wear a costume. So I've been working on, making a mushroom hat, which I think is probably too big for me to get on my webcam, but, I think it's turning out really cool. I'm hoping I can get it finished for the Halloween market, but that's kind of been a huge project. And I've been working on these little sculpts. I've got a whole bunch of little pumpkin toads. I don't know if you were here earlier when I showed those. And we've made this little owl, who's not baked or painted yet, but I think he's going to be real cute once he is. I think he's looking pretty cute already. And I've got a whole sheet of unbaked ones over here I haven't baked yet. I've got this little toad with the crystal. This one we did today on stream. If you were here early, you probably saw that. So we've been pretty productive. Oh yeah, I did this little toad earlier. That was fun. I gave him a little a little stone, so it looks like he's got a little crystal ball. And then I did a cat last night, which I think turned out pretty cute. A little bit bigger. Pretty cute. Thank you. Oh, thank you so much. I have a lot of fun sculpting these. And hopefully I'll sell some at the market. How have you been doing, Shy Wolf? Have you been making anything lately, or up to anything fun? It kind of depends on, Well, that's one of the things I have a hard time is pricing them. But it kind of depends on the size of them. I think some of my smaller toads that are just toads without any, like, crystals or bottles or little added thingies, I think I usually sell for about $13. My bigger ones like this, little owl, or like the toad with the crystal, can be anywhere between, I price them about $17 to $20, depending. And then some of my biggest ones I've done, I did some possums a while back, and I've done some foxes, and I've priced them usually between like 35 and 40. Yeah, it is kind of a bargain, and I know I've seen people sell polymer sculpts for a lot more expensive online, but you know, here in Indiana, people just don't spend that much on sculpts, so I gotta price them at a range where people are actually gonna buy them. Now I was thinking after my last market in November, I might put some of these up on my Ko-Fi shop. Actually, I probably will. There's probably no might about it. I'll probably put some of these little guys up on my Ko-Fi shop. And then I'm going to have to figure out how to price them as far as like how I'm going to ship them and stuff like that. So that'll be a whole thing I'll have to figure out. Glad it's the weekend. Yeah.
Cat.
I actually think this little owl might be done. And I think I might take a little bit of a break. And then what I might do is I might come back and play a little chicory. Have you ever played chicory or watched anyone play chicory, Shy? It's a really fun game. Oh, it's really fun. I think I have the video up still of my first stream, so if you want to see like the little introduction of it, you can. Basically, there's these little cartoon animals and they live in this world. And the world does not have any color in it unless there's an artist in charge of this magical paintbrush, and they create all of the colors in the world. Well, something happens to the one in charge of the paintbrush, and she gets in kind of a funk, and you're playing as the character, or her name's Chicory, and you're playing as a little character which you get to name your favorite food. After your favorite food, and you get to run around with the paintbrush and color things in and try to figure out what's going on and why the world has lost all its color. And it's a really, really cute game. The color schemes in it are a lot of fun. You get to kind of doodle and color things in as you go through the game, and there's little puzzles and stuff to figure out. So it's a really cute game, and I might get on and play that a little later. But I think for now I might stop and take a little break. Thank you for stopping in, and thank you so much for the gift sub and the sub from yourself. I hope you enjoyed watching me sculpt. This is my first time trying to sculpt on stream or do any kind of traditional art on stream, so it was kind of a new experience for me. But I think it was fun, so I might have to try it again. It sounds weird and interesting. Yeah, that's basically kind of how the game is. It's kind of weird and interesting. Oh, thank you. Alrighty, well, I'm going to stop now. Let me see if I can figure out what I'm doing.